Thank you. How are you feeling up in here, Atlanta? You guys know that this is the first sellout of the whole tour, right? That means you're the very number one best. I'm telling you, we gotta come to Atlanta more often. I'm sorry. I'm so happy to see so many people here singing our songs. Thank you for staying nice and late and watching us. Especially those people who might not know who Skillet was. Thank you for hanging out, having a great time with us. I want to tell you a story very quick about my life. My whole life, as much as I can remember, I have never struggled believing that God was real. I know you guys have been hearing about Jesus all night long. It's okay if I say one thing about Jesus before we move on. You don't mind, right? I never struggled that God was real ever since I can remember. Never struggled believing that God was going to come at the sun, come up the next morning. This never crossed my mind my whole life. But I have struggled at times in my life believing that that same God who keeps this universe going cares about what's happening, that he's listening to me in my everyday problems, in my everyday life. Sometimes I question that. Can anybody relate to that here? I was raised in a Christian family, probably like lots of people here. My mom was a Jesus freak. We got Jesus freaks here tonight, I suppose. And hello. I would like to actually, how many parents are here? Hands in the air, we got parents? Look at all these parents here, I love them, they rock. Some of these parents know they rock a little harder sometimes than everybody else, but. How many parents are also Jesus freaks? We got Jesus freak parents here now. Yes. My mom was a Jesus freak fanatic. My mom taught me about Jesus every single day. She would not let me listen to rock and roll. And they wouldn't let me wear black. So I'm paying them back big time. It's the best color. Anyway, when I was in sixth grade, we found out that my mom had cancer. And this might sound silly to some people, but I remember thinking, how could God let my mom have cancer because she loves God so much? And my mom would teach me, she'd say, John, if I die from cancer, you cannot be mad at God because God is always good. How many people believe that tonight? You can't be mad at God because God is always good. So I said, okay, I'll remember that. My mom fought cancer for 3 years, surgery, chemo, radiation, watched my mom shrivel away. She passed away when I was 14 years old. And I remembered I'm not allowed to be mad at God because he's always good. And I handled it pretty well until something happened that I did not see coming. And my dad got remarried 2 months after my mom's death. And me and my dad started hating each other. We fought, screamed at each other, did hateful, terrible things to one another. I hated my father. I wish that he could have been the one that had died. And I just used to want to hurt my dad all the time. I thought maybe I could just pray, God, would you please let my dad try to physically abuse me one time so I could have a chance to hurt him. I hated that guy. I got tired of being told I was a loser, never gonna be good enough. I was an embarrassment as a son, ashamed of me, wish I'd never been born. And at age 15 years old in my room, I said, God, I know you're real. I've never questioned whether you're real, but I am not sure that you are listening to me right now. Because I'm hurting every single day. Every day is worse than the last. And I need to know you tonight, not just as a God that keeps this world spinning. I need to know you tonight like a daddy. And I need to know you like a friend tonight. An amazing thing happened in my room at 15 years old, alone at night, around midnight. When I finally found out that the God of the Bible wasn't just something I read, he wasn't just 2,000 years ago, but that the God of the Bible is alive today, and he gives a hope like nothing else in this world could ever give a hope. I found out that Jesus wasn't just something I read about, and that just died for me, but he died for me that I could be recreated. And all that anger and all that angst and all that hate could just fall away, because all of a sudden it didn't matter so much anymore. At age 15, when my biggest, darkest secret was wanting to hurt my father, the love and hope of Jesus came in my life. That's why I'm here to tell you tonight, no matter what you are going through at your house, no matter what your darkest secret is, fighting with your kids or your parents, your spouse, divorce, being bullied at school, what I can tell you is this: there's a God who is listening. There's a God that is hope. And it doesn't mean everything's gonna be awesome every single day. It means that he's gonna be with you when things are not awesome. And you can just lean on him, and he'll be a daddy to you. I meet so many people that just say, yeah, I don't know about this Jesus stuff. All that I know is that in my life, I just don't feel right. I think the best way I ever heard it explained is that somebody said, every one of us human beings, we have a feeling that there has been something that we have lost and we can never get it back again. That's the emptiness that we have that only Jesus can fill. That's what Jesus says. He's the only hope. He's the only peace. He's the only life. Maybe tonight is your night to find out that the God of the Bible isn't just something we talk about at church, but that he's real. He wants to make you new. He wants to teach you about hope tonight. That same God that keeps this earth going, the sun and the moon and the stars, he keeps it all in place. That is the same God who knows your name tonight in your room at midnight when you're hurting. This song is called Stars.